But she wouldn't listen.
He was doing his best.
She never, ever listens.
Why didn't she listen to him? Trying to help her.
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zinbel was right.
Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
So.
But she wouldn't listen. And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. It's all her fault.
All her fault.
She's so weak.
She should have known. She should have known.
Why doesn't she learn?
When she learns, she doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never find her.
She's let the darkness in.
It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless even trying to retrieve it. She's lost.
Where is she going? She's got to go deeper to find the head. Deeper towards the darkness.
The beast is there.
The beast is luring her deeper, deeper into the darkness.
Down.
The beast has the head.
She's got the head.
She will be trapped.
The beast has the head and he's losing it.
Once she gets down there, she'll...
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that point. And he takes the treasure. Sigurd kills the dragon. Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, He understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
And she'll die.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rhian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rhian before Rhian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sleeps an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the birds of ice. He kills Rhian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest to ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild the Valkyrie.
Thank you. I can smell you.
No!
You betrayed your god.
I am leaving with him.
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillion is rotting now.
Has to fight him.
Fight!
Dillion.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel.
He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole.
She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness.
Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Dillion would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul, even if this time. She can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore. But believe this, it was my mission to make you hate, to hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. For without it, I fear you would have let go of this life. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. That you have conquered your darkness at every turn.
Stay alert, Senua.
You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me into
the
mountain.
He wants her to trust him.
As deep as we can go.
No.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him. Follow it.
You will not survive what is in there.
Gaze, searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Dillion. I will fulfill my vow. Is it? Mother, you showed me how to see further. To see the hidden wonders in our world and explore new paths into the unknown. To lead so that others may follow, or to warn so that they may avoid. That is our gift and our duty. I'm not going to look away in fear anymore.
the destiny of the gods. First, there will be a terrible winter, 3 years long. Then, mankind will turn on itself. Brothers will fight each other to the death, and people will forget what they owe their kindred. Times will be hard. Crimes will be great. It will be an age of axes and swords. The wind will blow through abandoned halls. Wolves will walk where children played. The world will fall into ruin. The land of the giants will thunder with the sound of their army on the move. The gods will assemble. The dwarves will leave their stones. The frost giants will come from the east. The Midgard serpent will turn up the waves. Eagles will scream and tear at the corpses with their yellow beaks. The ship of the dead will set sail.
There's a way.
She can see.
She must align herself. She can do it.
There's the door.
She aligns herself. It's there.
Say that at Ragnarok the gods will face a ship full of their foes, which Loki has steered to Asgard. It carries the fire giants, the wolf that will eat the sun, and all kinds of dark creatures. Surt will join them with his sword of fire. The cliffs will crash, trolls will walk the land, men will tread the road to hell, and the heavens will split open. Sink into the sea, the stars will disappear, fire and water will meet, steam will shoot up, flames will play against the sky, the heavens and earth and all the world will be burned, all the gods will be dead, and the warriors of Valhalla and the people everywhere. Senua, prepare yourself for Ragnarok, for it is nigh.